cooldown is over 2.5 minutes long on the side of Akali, so No Man should have the safety he needs to survive in that mid lane.
One push jumps to shove. It's time for the Kabe Jin. Bouncy looking pretty good. Xerxe, is he going to go for the play? Of course, you have the oranges, but it won't stop the knockup.
Oh.
Bit awkward there. Pizzachachi walking down, trying to look tasty, but here comes Xerxe. Red buff the flat forward. The fear now proc. Boss is going to need to get out, but he's not going to have a chance. First blood comes through.
And remember that where No Man thinks it's going to be beneficial is the fact that he will be able to scale up and then become very strong.
Oh, potentially a big mistake from NX stepping forward there. Black Shield now already used. Xerxe's just going to walk his way in. Edward in trouble. The exhaust comes out. Surely set to fall. Xerxe grabbing yet another kill, but Humanoid on the way.
Humanoid on the way. There's 4 versus 1 under the tower. NX, he's going down.
Xerxe taking the tower for now, just getting the setup, just trying to make it as clean as possible. Kabe just gonna fade away there. Captive audience indeed. So easy to land the deadly flourish on that one and knock him out.
Hey, this early game already reminding me of day one Xerxe, but now Nanasik trying to make his move in the top lane. Pizzachachi does have the flash, but not a lot of HP.
And level 6.
He can turn this.
He can just try to commit to the play here. Knockup does not connect, though. Maybe this is the moment where they can turn. Boss can't get any lower, but he practices grass. The flash forward, the silence. Chachi wants it so bad, but he's just walking away. That is one very alive pirate and one very dead void monster. He's going to get knocked up. Beast is on the way. And Anasik's going to try to jump over the wall, but there is definitely someone waiting for you there in the darkness. How fitting. And Anasik now forced to flash away. Humanoid's there, too! How many people are going to stand in front of this man? There was no path out. He jumps. Surprise.
As opposed to the Caulfields and Blue Smite on the other side is a bonus 40 AD for the Nocturne, which is a gigantic.
High risk. Again, I think very high risk, but he does have pressure on the top side, so it won't cost him too much. Needs to be careful, though. Ulti now coming in. Might want to turn his sights on a Pizzachachi. He doesn't even know Humanoid's there. Time for a bit of stealth and time to leap away. I don't think it's going to be enough. Ooh, he's juking, but it's not good enough to stop Humanoid chasing him down. Is there another proc on the ult? Won't even matter. One more auto. Humanoid just cleans.
The push does come through. I think Boss can use that to stall out a counter siege from the side of Splice.
They're going to go for the dive on either side, though. Nocturne ulti now coming in. Black Shield goes golden. Uses the stopwatch. Tries to buy a bit of time. Xerxe gets out of the tower. He turns onto Norskaren. Norskaren, the perfect highway, the perfect avenue of escape. They're going to get that kill as well. But the hook still goes through from the corpse of Norskaren. Inax is going to be forced to flash away. Kabe trying to swag it off, but it can't happen. But no, Humanoid here to clean up the fight. Splice coming on top for now. The flash right into the binding. Here comes the curtain call, but it's not going to be curtains for anyone. One more, maybe? One shot connects. Humanoid wants to finish it off. No Man's there to block. Not even necessary, but now he's rooted. The stopwatch kills him. This is an insane skirmish.
Sight and top lane.
And Chachi's still getting dived. The knockup is there. Anadasik goes in. Anadasik goes golden. They're going to finish it off. One shot, one kill. No,
he's taking the tower.
Visit Chachi. It stops NX.
Unbelievable. Which is going to be so brutal when trying to set up ganks onto Boss in side lanes. You run him down with Xerxe coming around, that's free kills every time.
The ultimate, trying to find the knock who will not connect onto Boss. Xerxe now locked him under the tower. The GP ult not coming out. Xerxe has to be careful, but Vizachachi's there to tank. He takes one too many. No, perfectly placed.
Oh.
He's still going to get the one for one, though. Messy.
To bully Boss here, probably because they think they have a better shot of diving a gangplank than a Kale.
I mean, Chachi is just getting tanked here. This tower is going to do negative damage to him in a few minutes. They're going to walk right under here. Boss, I don't think he can make his way out of this one. Chachi tanks a few extra shots, and they pick up the kill. It's been a long time since you've seen a tank in the top lane, but that is the power. It's
right there, they're able to push out that lane and deny minions. I actually wonder if this is the type of game where you mind leaving that tower up to keep looking for dives as bot lane. Dive in progress.
Ulti comes out. Humanoid Joe just waiting. Can leap back in right as it falls. No Man's backing out. Black Shield is there. Humanoid shut down. Tons of gold now going into the pocket of the Cossacks. They're going to grab the tower as well. Just as Splice grab one. Very even play, but now the GP might just be dead once again. It's not even the GP. It's the Kai'Sa trying to leap to safety. Pizzachachi on the hunt. Not going to be enough. That's attack on Titan if I've ever seen it. Way too easy for Pizzachachi to just walk up and auto that one.
All right, so both sides of the map going to be trading here right now. Going to be missing from Xerxe. Humanoid should have it up soon, so Splice will want to pull the trigger.
Now in trouble. Anadasik in a sidestep there. Xerxe has to run for the hills. Pizzachachi now running into the midst of the team. The flash out from Anadasik. No Man's needs to retreat. Kale ult not available. That should be one dead Kale. Pizzachachi grabs that one. Curtain call now comes out. They're behind the play. That makes the Jin so incredibly strong. One more shot. Will not connect. Good patience from Anadasik to hold onto the leap. But still, Edward will get knocked up. Still, the Jin is chasing down. Boots of Swift is tearing him in. And a beautiful hook from Norskaren. Two more for Splice, and their gold lead just explodes.
Splice knew the window they needed to find the fight right there with the spells, with the items under their belt. And now they take full control as they look for even more. Pizzachachi gets taken. But I really have to question why Unicorns think fighting there is so key, because all of their ultimates were down, or at least 4 of the 5. Edward
even more on the back half. Now Humanoid's hunting. Trying to find the knock, and the Black Shield is now gone. The Nocturne just goes in. They're just going to pick him off one at a time. This composition is merciless. Doesn't even need the four shot to
this river, and Humanoid sitting there waiting to just blow up the first target.
GPL comes out, but it's not nearly as much damage as they need. Humanoid now playing with his food, trying to buy time for the rest of the team. Norse Garen locked down, but he's not the center of attention, and that means the Baron will drop in favor of Splice. Humanoid now going to retreat. The flash forced out. Unicorns of Love getting
three members, and then looks to collapse with Xersei, either top lane or bottom lane. Free dice.
Garen, though, caught out. Maybe this could be a difference. Kabe walking forward with a four shot. They're going to do a chunk of damage to the GP, but they're still able to close this one out.
Level 11, so he has the evolved Q and W for that extra slow from range. Could be effective at chasing down Humanoid.
Running. Using the movement speed from the Shroud as well as he can. Trying to walk away. Edward now fishing. The root is there. They take him out instantly. No longer does the Shroud offer perfect stealth to duck every single point of CC.
Splice are going to try to trade this for two towers at the same time, though, but Unicorns will lick their wounds with this one. This should be effectively the end of the Baron push with 30 more seconds.
He can't afford to make it.
He's got a righteous glory. He's just chasing you down.
He's going to walk straight in your face. The ulti now coming out from the Nocturne. Invisible trying to bide as much time as he can, flashing away from the fear. Barrel comes in. Xersei will back. Oh! Right over the wall. Without a single member available. Well, four strong have to try to. The Nocturne alone is more than enough to take this. The Kha'Zix was dead at the start of this, so they can't just wait for the pick. It costs them nothing to try to set that up.
You know, chunk him out a little bit. Let's be real, you're not going to kill him. He has the Warmogs to heal on up, so you must attack Humanoid, but that's a three-level lead.
Still doesn't matter. The Kha'Zix invisible wants to change. No!
It matters. It matters.
It absolutely matters. Humanoid. Now trying to run away from this one. No Man's can hopefully clear it out. The one for one. Not ideal, but not bad. The shutdown. Action here. Maybe Boss can be the difference maker. No Man's. If he has to burn his ulti here, it's going to be less than ideal. Vizachachi runs right into the Kale. Despite the adaptive helmet, good damage comes out, but it's not enough. The ulti comes in, stopping Xersei's ult. But now the ultimate comes in from Kabe on the backside as well. The perfect call, the shutdown now into the jungler. They just did not have the full team there. Humanoid is still down. Norse Garen now has to run for the hills. The hook goes wide. The box buys a bit of space. Chachi sees an opportunity, though. He flashes forward. He's looking for a little bit more, but Anonisic can just look to clean up. He's half-held by Kabe. But now
here comes Humanoid.
The win. Humanoid on the backside. Eyes on the Akali. One shut down. But the Akali can't just clean up. UOL. They'll just look like food to the rest of the team. Humanoid, can he go in? The ultimate
he goes.
Is available. He wants to get one. He gets shut down in an instant. I can't believe it. It seemed like a clean, easy closeout for the side of Splice, but UOL find their moments.
Unicorns of Love find the fight in the jungle right there. The 5v4 as Splice get caught out. And now, unless there's some miracle to come through with Kabe's fourth shot, there is no smite for Anonisic. They're actually going to try and wait him out right here. They waiting for the reload. They see him on the ward on the other side.
Oh. Will not get it.
On the side of Humanoid. When you get these shutdowns against people that are higher level than you, you get Humanoid so much bonus EXP.
He's just going to get deleted. Tries to buy as much time as he can with his own. He can't even make it out of this one. He's running for his life. But Inax now on a killing spree. And Anonisic going to run away. Kabe's still a massive threat. Nocturne all just to stop the play in its tracks. There will be a knock up there. GP still willing to move forward. The play does not connect. Norse Garen has a hook to dissuade a further dive, but they're just barreling down the mid lane. Unicorns of Love are unrelenting. They want to use this Baron buff as best
they can. Look at their items, too. Three items on both No Man's and Inact. They have the defensive tools. Hail ultimate, Zonya's for Morgana, a stopwatch for No Man's. The dive of Splice, I actually don't think is enough to kill the Unicorns anymore. Eyes have to be on those two players to be pumping out the DPS and to be staying alive until the end of the fight.
Chachi, very big. Trying to shred through him, the GP ult's coming in, but they're just grouped up right into the GP ult. Half health, about a third of the health taken out. The hook will not connect, Norse Garen now in trouble. And Unicorn's Love are just walking
look
down
at the
mid
lane.
Where's the turn gonna
go?
Oh, he goes to the backside, the Kai'Sa! That combo was sick, but Humanoid, he can be the difference maker. He can be the one to clear it up. Here comes the curtain call. Humanoid to the backside, but he's been revealed. The shutdown is there. They've stopped the Kai'Sa. Splice are just backing off. What are these bats being channeled? They have to contest this one. They can't afford to give this one up. TP now coming in on the backside. That could be the difference maker. What is going to happen? Vizachachi in the midst of everything. Curtain call now coming in. Humanoid can start to look to hunt. Multiple members slowed up, but a beautiful binding from Edward will stop that play. Instead, the Baron, the center of attention. A lot of chunked health bars on the enemy team.
Unicorns of Love coming in around on the corner. It's down to his about 6,000 HP. They're going to poke them down.
Right in the GP ult. That's not where you want to be. No Man's just does 40 flashes, and he's not afraid. Humanoid in the backline. Can he be the difference maker? He goes gold, and he buys time. He buys space for the team. I don't think it's going to be enough. The hook comes in. Edward, not the target they needed. Humanoid down. Five strong in the UOL.
Anonisic
doesn't even get hooked. Norse Garen so low. Prey Seeker goes
in.
He sends it to death. That's it. The side step from Kabe costs to support life. Vizachachi, you're so tanky, but it does not matter. The Cho'Gath going to get walked down here. They cut through Vizachachi's health bar. No Man's on a kill.
Unicorns ever left Berlin. The crowd still chanting their name. And now they have in this game, Unicorns, they do. And now they have an inhibitor tower on top.
And they're going to walk in. They're going to break an inhib. Humanoid still fishing for a flank. 25 is the base plus the additional single dragon. Humanoid, maybe this is the different fight, but the hook does not connect. Boss continues to step forward, continues to poke. Visichachi doesn't take any damage, but the rest of his team sure does. The rupture not going to matter much. UOL are just walking in and taking objectives from Splice. There is nothing they can do.
They're going to keep taking more too, Draco.
They're saying Humanoid can come in. They can try to be invisible. But of course, the tether from Morgana denies that Akali invisibility, something we have to keep our eyes on. The tower goes down, Chachi's caught out, the lantern will take him
and
back.
And whack away at this tower.
Mid lane is crashing, bot lane is crashing, those super minions, someone has to answer them. Someone also has to answer the five strong of UOL on the top side. Inax goes in, he forces Norse Garrett back, but he's used the ultimate. One defensive tool is gone to the side of the Unicorns of Love. Splice, trying as best as they can to hold on, but they're just gonna have to walk away. They're gonna have to give up their third inhibitor. And if Unicorns Love, don't make a mistake. If there's no opening, that might be it though. Anonisic getting over. Lock onto Visichachi. Ward gets placed down, but will not stop Visichachi from exiting. Ulti now comes out. They've bonded out on the Kale, but the Kale is going to stop that right in his track. Cersei now going to be in the middle of the team. It's not going the way that they want it. Visichachi with the stone plate. Proc is not tanky enough. Kabe has to run for the hills. The Kaz is just trying to find it, but a hero hook from Norse Garen will keep him alive. Splice have remained alive in the game, and now they want to turn a humanoid. This is the moment that he's been waiting for. The hooks from Norse Garen. They finally connect. It was a long drought, but Spice are back in this game. The shutdown comes through, and they're looking to take control.
Look at the base, though. Minions in on the Nexus. The towers are going to go down. They have to teleport back before they lose everything. They cannot start up the Baron.
And we're buying time. Spice, hold on, but they have not won the game. Not yet.
Even after the one fight where they have to commit so much to go forward for the Unicorns of Love, all they have to do is hold their position around the Baron. That is the second Elder.
Dropping. Baron getting lower and lower. No Man's just shredding through this one. Humanoid now moving in. Can they move over the wall? Can they steal this? They have the
Chachi!
The flash in! The Beast! There is no chance to contest against the likes of a Kyogath, and the fight may still turn against them. They're trying to get it out. Comes the curtain call. Humanoid still off to the side. Visichachi still going down. The rest of UOL will retreat. Splice take the Baron, a well
look at him!
Inax goes in, takes out the jungler. This could be the difference maker. It's still five members strong from the enemy team. Inax will not bite off more than he can chew, but Humanoid has something to say about the rest of the team collapsing. If he kills Inax, maybe they hold on. Maybe he could be the difference maker. Humanoid gets taken down in the exchange, though not worthwhile. Two members left on the side of Splice.
Splice stole the Baron, but they lost three members for it, and that is an exposed Nexus for 30 more seconds. At least minions coming down in the top lane. The Unicorns of Love have only one structure standing in their way, and a game one victory against Splice. It is just Kabe and Norse Garen left to try and defend against this siege, and the Unicorns are gonna take it all.
They're gonna take the game, and there's nothing they can do. Unicorns of Love take it to the late game, and they take down Splice.